Things have changed, and meeting your neighbors isn't always as sweet as it seems in sitcoms. This evil neighbor hits the fence daily, but Dad finally gets shocking revenge. There was a loud crash and a scream. Months of frustration had all come down to this moment. The homeowner finished his sandwich calmly. He knew he was going to have a fight on his hands. He might as well fuel up while he had the time. More than anything, Caleb wanted to settle into a quiet life. He'd had enough of fighting, but he wasn't going to back away from a fight either. He tried, he really did. He had big plans after moving into this new house, but nothing was going according to plan. Just a few short months before, Caleb had been in a combat zone. As a Marine, he saw way more combat than any person should ever see. What he didn't see was the birth of his children or their graduation from kindergarten. He wanted to ensure that he didn't miss out on anything else. He loved being a Marine and he would always be one, but it was time to focus on his family, so he retired. For the first time, the family would live off base and have their own home. It was a time of first. It would also be the first time in Caleb's adult life that he would live as a civilian and have time for hobbies. He was looking forward to slowing way down. They searched for a house in a nice neighborhood and found a place they loved. The garden was a little rough, but that was part of the appeal. Caleb couldn't wait to start gardening and creating something special for his kids to play in. They moved in, and for the first few weeks, things were amazing. When they lived on base, they knew many of their neighbors, so they went and met some of the neighbors. They wanted their kids to have friends, but they didn't get to meet everyone since some of the neighbors weren't home. It was a nice neighborhood, and in the next few weeks, many of those who had not been there came to say hello. It was fun making a home. His wife and kids had never been able to create a home without being worried it was going to be uprooted. It was exciting. As soon as he could, Caleb started working in the garden. They had a corner lot, and it gave him plenty of space for all his projects. The first thing he wanted to do was make the corner of the lot pretty. It would be a nice sight for everyone driving by on the road. He made a nice soil flower bed. Then he got his kids to help, and together they planted a bunch of happy flowers all along the flower bed. It was a great project for them to do together. Everyone was excited, but that excitement was soon going to turn into sadness. The next morning, Caleb's daughter called him crying. Something horrible happened to their beautiful garden. All the flowers were scattered and broken. Tire tracks went straight through their flower bed. It even looked like someone went through it more than once. They couldn't believe it. Someone had destroyed their pretty garden. It was over the weekend, and Caleb thought that it was probably some youngster who had partied a little bit too much and couldn't make the corner. It was disappointing, but if life in the Marines teaches you anything, it's not to give up. And this Marine dad was determined to instill those same lessons in his kids. He helped them replant the garden and save any of the flowers they couldn't save. But when they came out the next morning, it was destroyed again. It happened each time they fixed it. This was not going according to plan. Who could be doing this? Caleb had to figure it out. He set up a camera in his yard and waited. Then he noticed that it was the same pickup truck cutting the corner every time. Could someone be that incompetent or careless? Or was this deliberate? Caleb had a mission. He needed to figure out what was going on here. He sat outside and watched for the pickup to go past. He saw it turn and go into a house not far from them. He decided to go over and speak to them. He genuinely hoped all it would take was a conversation. Maybe they didn't realize someone was now living there? The house had been empty for a while before the family moved in, and it might just be a habit of the driver. He went over, and a woman opened the door. She was super friendly. It was her husband's car and he wasn't around. But she promised to let him know and it wouldn't happen again. She didn't explain why it happened, but Caleb wasn't looking for a fight. As long as he stayed out of his yard, Caleb would be happy. Besides, it would be a lot harder to do damage very soon. The corner lot was large and they wanted their kids to be safe playing outside in the yard, so they planned on setting up a fence. The kids had been begging for a dog too, and that was the plan. A fence would keep everyone inside and safe, and hopefully the pickup truck driver would see the large solid fence and stick to the road. they started planting other things behind the house while they waited for the fence to arrive. The kids had lost a bit of their joy for gardening after all the disappointment, but planting vegetables and knowing they were going to eat what they grew started getting them excited again. To Caleb, it was incredible to spend all this time with his children. They painted the kids' rooms and he could make breakfast for all of them. For a long time, his wife had been the primary carer. Now he could take a lot off her plate. He started working again, but he was home every day. Life as a veteran was awesome. He did have his struggles to adapt, and there were times when he had to take a deep breath to keep his anger at bay, like when his flowers got destroyed. But overall, it was great to be around his family at all times. The day the fence arrived was exciting. Caleb knew he would feel a lot safer having that extra layer of protection for his family, and he also had another surprise coming the next day. The first part of the surprise was to get the fence up. Caleb and his wife worked together, and they built the fence themselves. It took a bit longer than they expected, but by the end of the next day, the fence was built, ready for the next surprise to arrive. The fence didn't go all around the house, just the back and the corner of the house. People could still reach their door. The children had just finished their dinner when there was a knock on the door. Normally, the kids weren't allowed to open without their parents, but this time Caleb told them to go. They opened, and Caleb and his wife laughed at their excited squeals. In front of the door were their grandparents with something special. They loved their grandma and grandpa, but at that moment the kids weren't even looking at their grandparents. All their focus was on the wiggly Labrador puppy that their grandfather was holding. They came inside and set the puppy down, and the puppy jumped happily between the children licking them and playing. Then Caleb made an announcement. It was their puppy. The kids jumped up, crying and hugging their parents. Their mom was wiping away tears of her own, and even the tough Marine was having trouble swallowing past the lump in his throat. His family had given up so much for him, it was awesome to start giving them back some of that. He tried to show his wife his appreciation every day too. For a few weeks, the fence did its job. Then, one morning, something horrible happened. Caleb's daughter took the puppy out to go potty. They heard a loud thud, and then they heard her calling and then crying. She was in distress and her parents ran to her. What could have happened? The fence had been hit, and Caleb was just in time to see the pickup driving off. It was the same annoying neighbor that still couldn't manage to stay on the road. He had cut the corner and again this time hit the fence. The fence was broken. At first, they were worried. Did he hit their daughter? The girl stood by the fence and she was bawling. They grabbed her and tried to see where she was hurt. She was crying so much she could barely speak. But at last, they figured out that she wasn't injured. Then they noticed something horrible. The puppy was gone. They asked her where he was and she could only point to the fence. The puppy had crawled through the hole in the fence where it got damaged. Caleb ran out and called the dog. It would break his kids' hearts if they lost the puppy. Some of the neighbors came out to see what was happening, and they started to help search for the pup. Caleb's heart was beating loudly. He was angry and anxious. It was worse than some of the missions he was on. The evil neighbor was messing with his kids and their happiness. He wasn't going to allow that to go on. It began to feel like war. Then, someone called. They found the pup hiding under some bushes. The kids were ecstatic, and Caleb and his wife were relieved. The pup was scared, but he wasn't hurt. But if their daughter or the pup had been in the wrong spot, things could have been very different. Caleb wanted to go over to confront the neighbor, but he knew he had to calm down first. He was too angry at the moment. He took a few days to calm down, but it had the opposite effect. From then on, the neighbor hit the fence daily. It was insane. Caleb could barely mend the fence before it was hit again. He wanted to phone the cops, but he also wanted to be neighborly. So, as soon as he could control his temper, Caleb once again walked up to the neighbor's house. This time, it was the guy, the owner of the pickup truck, that opened the door. And from the moment he looked at him, Caleb knew this wasn't gonna end well. The guy looked anything but repentant. Instead, he looked as angry as Caleb felt. He didn't say hello or anything, he just asked what Caleb wanted. Thinking of his family, Caleb tried to remain calm. He explained why he was there. He wanted to understand how the guy drove when he couldn't stop cutting the corner. The guy just laughed. Then he said something that shocked the Marine. In a super mean voice, he asked Caleb if it was hard for someone to come into his home and look for trouble. He went on to say that it was almost like he made a career out of going to other countries and looking for trouble. The guy had an issue because Caleb was a veteran. All the worst theories and suspicions came true. The guy had to have been doing it deliberately. He was destroying Caleb's property because he didn't agree with what Caleb had done. Caleb was furious. He could destroy the guy with his bare hands, but he wouldn't do that. His family was more important than anything. Destroying this guy would only hurt his family. And then the neighbor's wife came out and she tried to calm her husband down. She asked him softly to apologize and he wasn't happy. He started shouting at her, and Caleb knew it was time to go. He could only take so much. He had to go home and breathe deeply. Then he started to plan. First, he would try the legal route. He called the cops and told them what was going on, but his cameras hadn't caught the truck. The fence was blocking the pickup from view. Only the damage could be seen. The police wanted to help, but without proof, they couldn't take the guy down. There was nothing they could do, but that didn't mean there was nothing Caleb could try. He wouldn't leave his family in danger. If the guy hit the fence when someone was behind it, they could be seriously hurt. Caleb would not have that. At first, he just kept the kids and the dog away from that corner, and he started to plan. The news was getting out. The rest of the neighbors noticed that the fence was damaged daily, and they stood behind the family. The evil neighbor was a renter, and he'd been horrible from the start. But they liked the wife, and that's why people put up with him. Until now. Caleb didn't know that the neighbors were making their own plans. It might have made a difference, but as it was, he was hatching his own. The evil neighbor hits the fence daily, and the dad finally gets shocking revenge. Caleb had to wait for the perfect moment, and that came when he noticed the couple packing up the pickup. They were going away for a few days. That would be the perfect time to put his plan into action. With the evil neighbor and his wife away for a few days, it gave Caleb the cover he needed. He fixed the fence, knowing it would stay fixed for a while. Then he went out and got a bunch of supplies. This wasn't going to be a little project, but it would get him what he wanted, sweet revenge. Plus, his family would, hopefully, be safe. He mixed cement, and it was hard work. He didn't normally work with concrete, as there were loads of easier ways to get the job done, but not today. He needed something strong this time. It just felt right. But all his thoughts weren't on revenge. It was going to be a fun project, too. He built the walls of his project and filled it up. The raised planter was exactly what he envisioned, but he made it family-friendly. On the wall closest to the house, he had his kids put their handprints and ages. He didn't want the precious memory to be on the two walls closest to the street, not when he knew the walls might not be in great shape for long. He built the planter very close to the fence, but with a solid wood fence, no one in the road would ever know it was there. He had removed and replaced many panels on that part of the fence, but he hoped that the next time would be the last. As the concrete dried, it got harder and stronger. It was a lot harder than a wooden fence. By the time he noticed the evil neighbor's pickup back at his house, Caleb was ready for him. The planter was built and it had dried. It was strong. All that was left was to wait. It wouldn't be long before they would have their revenge. The dad made sure his children and the dog were tucked in for the night, and then he sat down and got ready. He ate his sandwich calmly. His wife sat next to him and she was on edge. She knew his plan and she was nervous. Would it work out, or was everything going to go horribly wrong? She wanted him to have his revenge, but she didn't want Caleb to hurt anyone. They sat for a while, and then suddenly they heard a loud crash and the sound of steel bending. Caleb finished his sandwich. He knew he would have a fight on his hands, and he might as well fuel up for it. It wasn't long before they heard shouting and cursing. Caleb told his wife to call the police and stay inside. Then he went out to see the damage, and there was a lot of damage. But instead of experiencing horror at the sight, all Caleb felt was satisfaction. The pickup truck was in his yard. It went straight through the fence like he did all the other times. But this time, the evil neighbor got a nasty surprise. The moment he went through, he went straight into the concrete raised garden bed. He was going so fast that the pickup lifted onto the planter. The side of the pickup was destroyed. He didn't get much damage from the fence each day, but this time he got way more damage than he expected. And the guy was not happy. He screamed at Caleb, shouting how he was gonna get him. Caleb could do some damage to this guy, but discipline stopped him. Then the police arrived. They could handle the evil neighbor further. He kept shouting that Caleb tricked him and how Caleb needed to pay for his truck. But that wasn't gonna happen. His hatred had caused him massive trouble. The police couldn't prove his actions in the past, but now they were clear. Not only wouldn't Caleb have to pay for anything, but the evil neighbor would have to shell out a lot of money. He had to fix his own truck. It was going to cost a lot. But he would also have to pay for the fence and the damage to the planter. He wasn't happy. And it would get even worse for the neighbor. The other neighbors had phoned his landlord and explained what was going on. He didn't know his landlord was retired from the Navy. Their lease was up and the landlord let them know they had to pack. The evil neighbor lost their home because of his hate. He had a damaged truck and no home. He had paid for his actions, but sadly his wife did too. Nor would she. The neighbors offered to help if she needed it, and a few years later she would take them up on it. But after that day, Caleb and his family put all of it behind them. He had gotten his revenge and his family was safe. That was all that mattered. They fixed up the house and made it a home. His kids got married out of the house, and Caleb and his wife lived there for a very long time. Living your best life is the best revenge of all. Do you think some people are just mean and evil? Thanks for watching. Join us again for even more incredible stories.